Sometimes I feel far, far away from my home. And sometimes I am lonely, but sometimes I like the way I roam.
Sometimes I pace forward, I pace back, yeah. Bending, breaking, tall grass shaking beneath my weight, yeah.
Sometimes I get stuck in between my
the roof, yeah. Fading narrow, bone shot arrow, harboring, yeah.
Sometimes I am tired of being alone, and I know sometimes I'll be mad.
Train lover, tune me up and spit.
Hello everybody, my name is Carlton Chamblin, founder of Farm to Cocktail, one of the sponsors of the 2020 Hambidge Art Auction. Visual art, in my opinion, has long been the truest expression of someone's deepest soul, and I'm delighted to be a part of that expression today. Farm to Cocktail is my truest expression of my soul. It's a cocktail company taking its roots from colonial days. Shrubs, as they are called, are drinking vinegars. During colonial days in America, they would take excess fruits and different crops and add sugar and then vinegar to preserve it. That acidic syrup is what I've created, and many of you all have received this in your gift package. Shrubs are great for making mocktails, which are non-alcoholic drinks, or cocktails. Today, I'm going to share my pear old-fashioned recipe. Taking a glass of ice, we're going to add some vanilla pear shrub. This is made up of barley pears, cane sugar, and apple cider vinegar, along with Madagascar vanilla beans. About 1/2 ounce will do the trick. We're adding that to a squeeze of orange to give it a nice essence. And of course, we can't leave out the bourbon. I would suggest about 2 ounces or more. Because of the combination of the vinegar syrup and the bourbon, I always like to top off my pear old fashions with a little bit of soda, not to dilute, but just to give it some fizz. Stirring that around. Adding a very decorative orange rind for your guests to enjoy. And of course, the cherry on top. So when you're sitting around this season and enjoying friends and family, cheers to the pear old-fashioned, and good luck during the auction tonight.
25 years ago today, when Mary taught the band to play, they've been going in and out of style, but they're guaranteed to raise the smile. So may I introduce to you the act you've known for all these years, Mary's Hambidge Only Hearts Club Band.
We're Mary's Hambidge Only Hearts Club Band. We hope you will enjoy the show.
We're Mary's Hambidge Only Hearts Club Band. Sit back and let the evening go. Mary's Hambidge Only.
Mary Hambidge Only.
Mary's Hambidge Only Hearts Club Band.
It's wonderful to see you.
It's certainly a thrill.
I love you.
You're such a lovely audience. We'd like to take you home with us.
We'd love to take you home with us.
I don't really want to stop the show, but I thought you might like to know that the singer's going to sing a song, and he wants you all to sing along. So let me introduce to you the one and only Jamie Badu and Mary's Hambidge Only Hearts Club Band.
From Atlanta, it's Saturday night.
Welcome to the first ever Hambidge Auction and Performance Primetime TV show. We look forward to bringing you an inspired, fun-filled hour highlighting the many ways that the Hambidge Center nurtures creativity like no place else. Today we need artists more than ever to help us understand who we are and where we're going. Artists show us the new paths forward with truth, respect, and joy. We need some of that, y'all. Truth, respect, and joy. We look forward to the day it's safe to host our big joy-filled art party again, but the heart of that is still beating wonderfully within the art that we have for auction tonight. There are incredible stories behind each work of art that come from across the globe. Slow down and see which one speaks to you, unless you're in the $100 buy it now section where you better be moving fast. I'm also proud to share that the heart of Hambidge has continued beating throughout this pandemic. With only a short closure to put new protocols in place, we've made for the sheltering in place is very easy for us, as you may well know. And we've served many artists, been the saving grace for many artists, while few residencies have been able to remain open. Tonight is one night of the year where we set out to raise over a quarter of our annual operating budget, while also offering 40% of the proceeds to the artist. Bid high and bid often, both Hambidge and the artist need your support. That said, special thanks to our presenting sponsor, PNC, and the long list of auction patrons and sponsors that have already chipped in their support. All of our performances tonight are headlined by strong and inspiring women, just like our visionary founder, Mary Hambidge. Tonight, we'll also take you around our historic 600-acre creative sanctuary, as well as our new home right here in Uptown Atlanta. We have special guests, great giveaways, and bet you'll be singing along with us by night's end. So don't touch that dial. First up, we're gonna head down to New Orleans to hear from Chloe of Rising Appalachia, along with a bird's eye tour of Hambidge.
Hey y'all, happy Hambidge gathering. I'm Chloe from the band Rising Appalachia. Hambidge is such an important place for us in the South. It's a refuge. It's a place of really powerful creativity. You can feel all the juju that everyone has put in there onto the land and into the homes. So we are very thankful to have that and to be part of the Hambidge family. So congrats, y'all, and hope everyone's doing well out there. This is a new song that I wrote right before the pandemic, and it's pretty synchromistic for the times. So it's called Stand Like an Oak, and it's available everywhere if you want to listen to it. Here we go. Stand like an oak, an aspen, an alder. It's in you, don't falter. And if so, then I got you. Fake it, walk taller. Anything that makes you feel smaller, leave them by the angels of the waters. Push them up, push them up. Put away your cares. Fold them, fold them, fold up your fears. Push them up, push them up. Put away your cares. Fold them, fold them, fold up your fears. He said, come to this river. Give me arms. Lean back. There's nothing to be alarmed of. He said, the more I know, the more I dig. And the more I return to myself around every bend. Put away your cares. Fold them, fold them. Fold up your fears. Push them up, push them up. Put away your cares. Fold them, fold them. Fold up your fears, fears, fears. Leave them by the edges of the waters. Leave them by the edges of the waters. Leave them by the edges of the waters. Leave them by the edges of the waters.
Wow. Thank you, Chloe. Stand like an oak indeed. Now let's share some love with all of our viewers out there. The next two individuals that email auction@hambidge.org will send Rising Appalachia's Lading Release out to them. Now let's head across the creek to the historic mill that Mary built.
All right, we're at location here at Barker's Creek Mill. We've got our longtime miller, Lawrence Holden, with us, and we're gonna grind some corn, y'all.
All right, let the bidding begin.
Thank you. Come and get them.
Kiss my grits!
We got your cornmeal and your grits. We run the mill the first Saturday of every month, so come see us for that. Or on the third Saturday of every month, we have nature hikes. We all need those these days. We look forward to the time when we can bring back the artist talks, which are the second Saturdays. But let's sneak over to Fisher Studio and see what Williams Downs is up to for us, working on a special project.
So we're ready to go in the studio?
Yeah.
Come on in. Oh yeah, you have a little earthworm, a little worm on you. I'm gonna grab that. Oh. Stuck. There we go. Keep going, buddy. The magic of being here. Welcome to the studio. So the drawings I'm making for an image is a series of ink wash drawings. And the process of ink wash is water and ink. I love this process because it's a surprise every time you connect the ink with the water. It's a very emotional medium. So that's kind of the nostalgic point of view that I'm making with these drawings. When you're driving up to Hambidge, you can't help but to think about the mountains. So that backdrop is fused in my brain. But that has also become the backdrop for the drawings that I'm making. The thing about Hambidge that you fall in love with is the togetherness of people when they gather here from all walks of life, all mediums, join in this beautiful connection and community. Those are the things I was thinking about as I was driving up here for making these drawings. With that, you can see how the figures float throughout, kind of like an animation. And the animation is kind of how you work your way through Hambidge, meeting people for a few minutes, go up to your studio work, then come back for dinner, and then that's when you connect. And after that, maybe there's a fire, or you go back up to the studio and work. So those are the things that I love about this place and the things that I miss when I'm not here. So the drawings are about togetherness, connection, connectivity, process, community, and the mountains, all in one package in these small little drawings.
A big thanks to William for creating that special project for us. And don't miss his show up at Mocha GA right now. We've got a couple more of these $600 care packages left. So I encourage you to jump on the internet and go ahead and grab yourself one. Let's take a look at what we got in here. If I can figure out how to open this thing up. Oh yeah. Of course, a William Downs drawing. We've also got, As many of you may know, we support chefs as well. So we've got a wonderful little scratchbook of recipes by some of our well-known chefs, including James Beard Award-winning chefs like Steven Satterfield and Lisa Donovan. Oops. We've got some spirits in here. We've got a wonderful photograph by Lucinda Bunnan. We've got some apple chutney. Yeah, lots to choose from, y'all. So don't miss that opportunity. And I'll also share, at the end of the evening, we'll give one of these away for those of you who are paying attention throughout the evening. William, like so many artists, also include work in the $100 work section. Check out that separate link in just below the video you're watching right now to access that. And they're going fast, so again, be ready. Now, okay, go ahead and take that away. Give that to our first customer. He's delivering them in the rain, so go ahead and chime in when you can. Now I'm happy to welcome the couple that helped us grow our music program by funding music fellowships since 2017. We're proud to have Margaret Anthony and Lee Eccles with us in the studio to introduce our next performance.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here tonight for the Hambidge auction, and Margaret and I are just thrilled to be involved with Hambidge, and particularly on the music side. And we've got a shared love of music. I think it kind of comes from New Orleans.
We love New Orleans. We love New Orleans music, and the innovation that we see there is just incredible. And to see the innovation that's come out of some of these fellowships has been amazing. And we're excited to see what's next.
The fellows that have been lucky enough to come to Hambidge have really run the gamut. We've had composers and Appalachian songwriters. And then our special performer tonight, Fielded, who we learned about when she came to Hambidge some months ago. We've now learned that she was actually writing music for the album that she's about to release, and that's very exciting. So you're going to love her. She's unique. She's spirited. She's passionate. All the things that you want in a Hambidge musician. So please welcome from Brooklyn, New York, Fielded.
It's called Talking to Myself because I wrote it while I was there. And these frog samples are actually from the residency.
I've been talking to myself in the mirror, saying things I never thought I'd say 10 years ago. I've been looking for myself in the mirror, but I only want to find myself if you are gone. And I know that when I come back alone, I'll be crying like the day I was born. So, and I dreamed about the blooming of the poppy, and I dreamed about two goddesses making a love, and I dreamed I fell through you and it was shopping. All the things I found inside that made me want to trust, and I don't know if this fire is the same. And will I ever gift a child a name? And are you coming back to haunt me? Coming back to haunt me again? So I've been sizing up the lighting of your mind. What are your oceans, baby? What makes you kind? And when you take me to the valley of your pain, will you be running wild, baby? Will you be something to take? I am way, 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 way beyond myself. Yet I am so, 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 so far behind. The way you should, the way you lose. Guess I will offer up my blessing for a bruise. So it's only if you want me. It's only if you want me. Yeah.
talking to myself. Thank you. Bye.
Brooklyn is in the house, y'all. Thanks so much, Fielded. I love that the frogs from Hambidge got in, made it into that song as well.
Bud.
Wise.
Ham.
Bidge.
Ham.
Bidge. Okay, well done. We're also have one-of-a-kind experiences up for bidding that get you outside. Get your very own 3D portrait and viewer from talented photographer Peter Bayouth outside in his famed tree houses, along with a special lunch by Tara Camarino. Also bid on Atlanta's most coveted gourmet dinner for one in the woods by Jessamine, or an outing with Henning at Hambidge, answering questions all about nature and, of course, anything that you would like to know about the natural world. Of course, with a special lunch as well. Later in the evening, we'll debut golf cart karaoke, our rural vision of James Corden's carpool karaoke. Let's first park that cart and hear why art star Dr. Fahamu Piku sings the praises of Hambidge.
So, you know, we sang Proud Mary in honor of Mary Hambidge. What are a couple of your favorite things about Hambidge?
Man, one of the things I love most about Hambidge is the silence. The silence at Hambidge is always like a welcome respite from that noise. You know, there's no television, there's no social media feed, there's no cars and horns and sirens, and you know, it's literally just beautiful silence and space to think and create and be. That's one of the things I love most about being at Hambidge. You know, the other thing I love about Hambidge is the community. You know, I've made some really amazing connections and friendships that have been lasting from those dinners, you know, at Hambidge. And, you know, again, you know, to have the space to, you know, kind of go into your own corner to retreat and then, you know, be able to come together over, you know, good food and fellowship at the end of the day and, like, be able to share the experiences, the breakthroughs and the epiphanies that I had in my cabin during the day, and have someone else be able to like echo that and say, yeah, you know, I discovered this today, or I accomplished this today, and you know, it's like a warm hug, you know.
Yeah.
So it's like a warm hug. It's like, yeah, job done well. And I love that. I always look forward to that when I'm at Hambidge. Is, you know, one, the silence, but two, the connections.
Yeah. Beautiful.
I love the idea of the word inspire. And you know how much I love words and wordplay. And we kind of take inspiration in the word inspire for granted because it's used so much. But when you really break that word down, you know, it really is about this spiraling energy inside of us, you know, and being able to access that, right? And so being able to go into that kind of solitude and quiet allows you the space to really go within. Right?
Yeah.
Access that fire and then put it out into the world in a way that's meaningful, that grows you, you know? You know, it really is like the physical manifestation of inspire.
Finding that true voice inside mm-hmm. you.
So yeah, let's go back up to the cabins and let's be inspired.
Let's do it. All right, here we go, y'all.
Like Fahamu, a lot of the artists speak to the powerful friendships and connections that come through Hambidge, where they find that fire within themselves. There's only 8 folks in residence at a time, the perfect number of people who fit around the dinner table. Around that dinner table are chefs, scientists, dancers, poets, writers, visual artists, musicians. It's really an incredible time for these artists to have a dialogue that they typically can't find. Over 170 creatives call Hambidge home every year, now with over 2,000 alumni from across the world. Next up, we're excited to welcome to the studio another one of our star fellows who received a 2018 recipient of the Leaders in the Arts Fellowship. And that's something that we just started offering folks to prioritize wellness and self-care alongside of their creative and administrative work. She does so much in our art community, and we're fortunate to have her and some of her dancers with us tonight to share a special performance, the wonderful T. Lang.
Thank you, Jamie. I'm really glad to be back. And again, I had a wonderful time doing my residency at Hambidge, and I'm pleased to show you all some new sketches from T. Lang Dance. I think you all should just spin around and check them out. Come on, let's go.
Thank you.
Thank you, T, and Morgan and Xavier for that lovely performance, responding to the artwork while bringing us through the galleries. We look forward to filling these galleries with all kinds of art forms going forward. This is only the beginning of our vision for nurturing all art forms here in Atlanta inside our four connected spaces spanning over 18,000 square feet. This space, which will soon be launching, is going to be the Uptown Cross-Pollination Art Lab with art studios, performance gallery, gallery space, and much more. We're really excited after 86 years putting roots down here in Atlanta. Now, let's fly back up to Hambidge to share the transformational expansion we are calling Hambidge 2.0, upgrading all existing studios and building new inspired structures to establish collaborative residencies, plus launch an array of new workshops and special programs to the broader public. We're really diving deep to welcome folks to Hambidge for the first time. We are essentially taking our residency model and offering this in the shape of immersive and intimate workshops in pottery, writing, painting, pie making, and much more. Furthermore, thematic residencies will bring together artists and thinkers to explore solutions around social justice, climate change, and other great challenges that the world's facing today. Now let's take a look at the setting for this new Antinori Village that we're so excited about. Welcome to the future site of the Antinori Village and the old lodge ruins here at Hambidge. Within this area, we're going to have a large porch and workshop and common area with dog trots that go up the hill. It's going to be an absolutely beautiful setting. Can't wait. Okay, we've now come to the serious part of the program where we ask all our viewers to stand up and support the transformational work that the Hambidge Center is doing today. This year we need your help more than ever.
The way this will work is I'm going to go through the donation levels. As you hear the support level that you wish to step up to, input the donation in GiveSmart or follow the directions on the text message you just received. We will parade your name around on air. Ready?
$10,000, y'all.
$10,000. That could keep the lights on at Hambidge for 1 year.
That's the electricity bill for a whole year. $10,000, can I get? I'm getting some beeps here already. We're working on it. Thank you very much, Lee Eccles and Margaret Anthony. $10,000.
Wow.
We'll take it. Let's keep moving.
All right.
$5,000.
$5,000 is the maintenance cost for our trucks and golf carts for the whole year. Here they come. Thank you for the donations. Thanks, Anonymous.
I'm being distracted by a flood warning. That's the good news of us being on TV.
Live TV. All right.
$5,000. We're moving on.
Next
one. $3,700. $3,700.
So $3,700 is the price for a Distinguished Fellowship. Jamie's going to explain what a Distinguished Fellowship is and why it's our most popular level.
So this is something that truly gives an artist 2 weeks at Hambidge and pays the artist $700. Doesn't matter what discipline. You choose the discipline that you want to support, and we name this scholarship for you. The artist comes to Hambidge, and they write their thank you note to you, the donor. Really a wonderful opportunity to truly see where your money goes here at Hambidge.
All right, next level.
next level. We're going to go to the $1,500 level. $1,500.
$1,500 covers an artist for 1 week at Hambidge. And we've already received two $1,500 donations from our friend Rosemary and our friend Wanda. Thank you so much. Keeping it going?
All right, we're going to keep going. Thank you very much. I'm seeing these donations coming in. After the $1,500 level, we're going to go down to $500 level.
Thank you. All right. So $500 keeps the grounds cut for the whole year. 600 acres, Jamie. That's a lot of lot of grass.
That's a lot. We got a lot of grass, y'all. Here we go. Okay. Blow. We don't use the blower much, but because we try to keep the sound level down. $500, y'all. Please step up. We'll appreciate it.
Thank you.
The next level we're going to jump into is $250. Who's got $250 to help us?
All right. So $250 is one communal meal for our residents at the Rock House. So that's the cost of one meal for eight residents at the Rock House.
And Chef Lori, I think all of our fellows will tell you that she cooks wonderful, wonderful, fresh, healthy meals. $250. Let's feed these hungry artists. All right, next up, $100.
$100. It covers the extra cleaning costs that we have per building since COVID. So we've upped our cleaning process because of COVID, and that costs some extra dollars. So thank you for your $100 donations to help us cover those costs.
Well done. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
And so this brings us, are we gonna go to what everybody's been waiting for now? Golf cart karaoke?
Yeah.
This brings us to the debut of golf cart karaoke, a more rural version of James Corden's carpool karaoke. With 600 acres, we've got lots of ground to cover. So a golf cart helps us get down the road a little bit. And it's always adds a little joy to the trip with a little music. So joining us on the golf cart karaoke was the wonderful auction co-chairs, Clay and Karen, with none other than Lucinda Bunnan, and then also starring Lonnie Holly, Fahamu Piku, and we picked up a hitchhiker who joined the band as well. So without further ado, golf cart karaoke from Hambidge.
I know.
Just keep in mind, everybody, that time doesn't disappear. It never goes anywhere. It just more life comes into it, and we have to participate the best that we can. And I think what Hambidge is trying to do here is bring you part of that life experience and say, hey, we want to keep on doing it for generations yet to come. That's right, Jamie.
Music is a world within itself, with a language we all understand, with an equal opportunity for all to sing.
Jesus. He's coming to know. This is too much for me.
He said he's going.
I'm going back.
He said he's going back to find.
Going back to find.
Going back to find. Ooh, 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 what's left of?
What's left of this world?
The world he left behind.
The world he left.
Not so long.
Go.
Okay, let's keep those bids rolling in honor of Proud Mary. And let's give some love to those of you watching. Our co-chairs were in costume for a colorful introduction at the beginning of the show. The first viewer to send in to auction@hambidge.org what classic song that was inspired by what they were doing. We'll get a Hambidge-grown care package. Let's sneak back to hear from our co-chairs now.
Thanks very much for joining us for this wonderful virtual evening.
Hambidge is so dear to our hearts, and we hope you've learned a little bit more about the amazing experience it affords the artists through the stories told tonight. On behalf of the host committee and the planning team, we want to thank personally each one of you, all of our patrons, for helping us make this new format something quite special. We'd also like to thank Jamie Badu for his leadership, his vision, Catherine Banks and Dana Thacker for unlimited dedication, as well as all of the Hambidge staff for their hard work and creativity. We thank you.
Thank you for your unwavering support for Hambidge. We look forward to a time when we can all be together again. From our house to your house, Hambidge.
Cheers. Oh.
Okay, that brings us to the end of our show, folks, but not the end of the auction. The auction closes at 9 p.m. Don't wait for the last second. Go ahead and put your max bid in and let the system bid up for you. That'll ensure that you're going to get that piece that you've fallen in love with. We're so grateful to all of the artists for participating, and all the artists that truly inspire us to move forward. Thank you all for joining in the fun tonight. Special thanks to our staff holding the fort down back up at Hambidge, feeding the hungry artists and keeping them safe. Christine, Andrew, Lori, Sammy, Julie, and Carol. How much have we raised thus far, Kathy?
Over $90,000.
Wow, okay, we're over $90,000, y'all. Let's keep the bidding up. We definitely want to get in over $100,000 tonight. Thank you again for everyone. And I think we need to go ahead and hit the music. Let's start this celebration. Yeah!